Hello and welcome to my reaction to a new show called Kamisama no Memochou, Evan's Memopad, a show from 2011, 12 episodes. It's I think manga adaptation. No, it's a novel originally, a novel that ran from 2007 to 2014, so yeah, this show is not going to be a complete story, as most shows are, so nothing surprising there. If you're new to my channel, I'm Exotic Bankai. I'm French, so my English isn't perfect. And yeah, if you're seeing the reaction to this first episode, it means that I like the show enough to finish it, because I always post the show after I finish them. So yeah, you can be sure I'll finish it if you're seeing the reaction. I have no idea what it is about. One of my rules is to not read the synopsis, to go as blind as possible. I have never heard about it. Basically, I was on my anime list looking for the most popular show that I haven't seen yet. And this one seemed to have been seen from a good number of people. It's by GC Staff, pretty well known. And yeah, it just seemed to be, it has a good rating, 7.55, and I haven't seen yet, so I figured might as well try it for a reaction. The cover of the show also is what made me want to watch it. It's a cute girl, possibly a loli, surrounded by a plushie, bear plushie, and I see a giraffe. So yeah, I have no idea exactly what it is. The title of the show doesn't really give anything away, at least. So yeah, really not much else to say. I got my version on NyaTorrent, and it's a 10.2 gigs version. It's just called Kamisama no Memochou. There's no fan sub listed. No, actually, the fan sub or the group is RH, so that's what I'm using. Dual audio. But obviously, I'm gonna listen in Japanese because fuck dub. Alright, let's give this a try. So episode 1, the runtime is, oh fuck, okay, I didn't know this before, but the runtime is 48 minutes and 42 seconds. I did not notice it was a double episode. Well, I have time, so whatever. Okay, wasn't in the plan, but eh, who gives a shit. Alright, audio Japanese. Alright, 0 second. Once again, the runtime, if you're on the same episode, is 48 minutes and 42 seconds. Let's get into this in 3, 2, 1. So, prostitute. Okay. Okay, I'm seeing some stuff. Interesting. Opening. Alright, interesting start. It's the only neat thing to do. Okay. Show looks good. I like the car design. Very grounded, nothing extra, I would say. Obviously no all over the place color. The opening really isn't telling me much about what this show is about. Okay. So it's a girl with a neat consulting and computer observing people, maybe. Okay. I don't think she's actually doing what she's doing. She's probably trying to bust a gear or something. Or maybe not. Okay. 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 Nice, but also nice landing. Okay, that turned out wrong. This is Japan. Even if it's a fake one, you can't just carry a gun like that. Is the girl like watching what's going on with camera? And then those guys go where she tells them to, I don't know, help people or something. The two or three things I know about her, page one. Same. Same. Cute childhood friend, I imagine. She sounds familiar. Kayanoai, okay. So not actually a childhood friend, okay. Hard to say no after that. This is like on YouTube, you sub to me, I sub to you. Alright, she's hyper. She sounds pretty young for a mom. Weird casting. I see she's a woman of culture. Or maybe it was his computer using Firefox. Okay. Yeah, I was going to say, what? Is that, yeah, we saw this place in the opening. Yeah. They're going to say it was in the Love Hotel district. She's out. I like her. Very nice. I guess 10 years ago, we still needed to explain what a meat is. I guess while I'm at it, I can say that I've got experience being in it. Not proud of it, but yeah, for many years. And right now, watching this show, I am. Unfortunately. Is it a BB gun? Okay. No time to read. Okay. What you mean a pimp? Okay, so I think I was right about the setting. She give them mission or something. Don't get what's going on. Okay. I mean, I get the joke, it's the only neat thing to do. Let's meet the star of the show. She is Boku. She's cute as shit. Voiced by Ogura Yui. I'll check what she's done afterward. I forgot this episode is twice as long. Weak. Okay. This is entertaining already. Deux coupés. Oh, Dr. Pepper. I assume. You couldn't get the sponsorship because in 2011 Steins Gate got it, I guess. Yeah. I think that's pretty obvious. Okay. Explain the difference. Yeah, okay, I see. Very talkative. Not really. I think I would have also asked that. It's a lot of fucking noise. But I guess with this many computer. Yeah. Okay, that's some weird logic. Don't get the logic. Okay. Irresponsible phrase. What does that mean? She's not making that much sense to me. Okay. Okay. So she doesn't actually care about the prostitution ring. She only did this for information about the girl she's looking for. She's very cute. The bear motif is funny, especially because right now, as I'm reacting to this season is a Kuma bear is airing, so quite a coincidence. I don't think they need to hear that. Wasn't expecting a detective show. I'm not the biggest fan usually, so we'll see how this turns out. Okay. The question is, why are those people following her? I mean, working for her. What's their relationship here? Were they saved by her in some way? I don't know. Okay. pulley. I've never seen that word before. Okay. Mokadits. That's the name. Yondaime. I was going to say. Okay. Butterfly gang. I don't think it's that heavy. I'm not into rap, but good music. Okay. I see, at least this show is using real program, you know? They're not making up a fake internet. Or computer as they usually do. This guy is annoying. I don't like him. Okay. Fair enough. Okay. Okay. What did you find? I'm terrible at mysteries, so don't expect me to figure anything out. Probably what I think. I was thinking porn, but maybe something more plus relevant. Okay, that's a great look. Interesting song. Yeah, I see. It would still count, but maybe not as much. That was obvious. Did the guy care? Did he kill her when he learned that she was prostituting herself? Is it as simple as that? Yeah, okay. Okay. Preserving a body. Oh, she killed herself. Damn, okay. But it, okay. It's a very busty woman as a news anchor. Okay. This feels a bit convoluted. What's the word? I don't know. Convoluted? That's not the word. No. Nice. Weird way to diffuse the tension and the morbidity from that story. Yeah, also fuck her. It's not his fault that he was there when the other one was trying to undress. Give me a second, I want to check if I'm still recording, sorry. Yeah, okay, still recording. I very rarely record more than a regular episode length, you know, so 25 minutes. Anyway, that was interesting. I don't really know how I feel about this episode and this show so far. I have pretty mixed feeling. I guess the first thing I should say and elaborate on is that I don't like detective story for the most part. I do watch them and I always find some element to enjoy. In this one, clearly I'm gonna enjoy the main girl. She's cute, she's entertaining. But yeah, I'm never a fan. I'm definitely too retarded to figure any mystery ever. And yeah, I don't know, I've never been the biggest fan. So yeah, remember that when you watch my reaction to this show. Still, I enjoyed this first episode, but I don't know how I feel about the mystery of this episode, how they came to the conclusion they came to, etc. I don't have detailed criticism about how it happened, but I don't know how I feel about it. Okay, there's an after scene. No, it's the... okay. But there's still a bit left after this. Okay, it's just some more credits. Yeah, as I said, I don't have any specific criticisms about the way the mystery was made, etc. But I don't know, it didn't feel that right, you know? I think it was interesting. I mean, I was definitely not expecting that kind of stuff in the first episode. Prostitution, self-harm, keeping a body in ice, suicide. I did not expect stuff like that. So I liked at least that for starter we start with something like that, which means this show won't hold back. We'll have some serious stuff going on. A lot of mystery show, even when they involve killing and stuff like that, they seem a bit childish. I've never watched Detective Conan, but that's what it seems to me, for example. But yeah, I don't like the main character. I mean, it's just a boring main character, pretty classic. I like a lot of the girl in this show, obviously. Yuko, the main girl. I like the energetic girl Ayaka. I liked Ming, she's a nice older lady. I wanted to check the voice for Yuko, she's voiced by Ogula Yui. Let's see. Okay, let's see. She was Katase in High School DxD, sorry. She was Sanae in Karakai Jozu no Takagi-san. Anything else of note? I'm not seeing anything big. A lot of loli, not surprising, okay. Nothing that big, but she's very cute and a very cute voice. Yeah, I'm a bit mixed about this show. I mean, is it really worth for me to do reaction if the only thing I give a shit about is the girls in this show? I think the mystery was still kind of good and the payoff and of the actual story was surprising, but yeah, I don't know. I'm still gonna continue it, but yeah. Just keep in mind that I might not be the best reactor for this if you're looking for someone who's good at figuring out mystery and enjoying mystery. That's not very much me. I guess, yeah, this first episode did need 48 minutes, you know, first introduce the setting, the character, and then a mystery to get the idea. I guess it's a good way to do it. I wonder if it's gonna be episodic where one episode equal one mystery. Yeah, not much else to say. I'm intrigued. I do feel like wanting to watch more, but I'm not fully into it yet. So yeah, anyway, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.